Hello and welcome to the show. I'm here on BeamNG Drive with a sort of challenge. I don't know if anything is going to survive it, but I'm going to be firing this cannon at various vehicles and seeing if they are still drivable. It is a rather huge cannon when we are parking it next to the the car here. The size of it is pretty much as long as the Grand Marshal, and yeah, we're going to see if any of them can survive being hit by this. It is a very powerful thing. I can't remember, there was a YouTube video somewhere, I can't remember who did it, that fired a cannon at a car, and it pretty much wrecked the entire, I'm not sure if it didn't even go straight through the vehicle. So yeah, we're going to fire the cannon at various vehicles and see if they stand a chance of surviving. Now, from head on, I think it's very unlikely, because this is going to smack the engine up, and yeah, it's not going to be very happy. So we press T on the keyboard. We are slightly twisted, but it's okay. Press T on the keyboard, and it fires the cannon, and we make a mess of the Grand Marshal. We press Tab to swap to the vehicle. It's done a lot of that. Admittedly, from kind of here, you know, it doesn't look too bad. We are... Oh, bloody hell, it's still working. That was me. I had the handbrake on by accident. I thought I'd taken that off, but... Okay, that's not what I expected. You've been hit by a cannonball in the face. Admittedly, the front left wheel does not really doesn't really do much. It can be off the ground. We'll be a tricycle. Whee, look at that for a big slide. Oh, yeah, the front wheels are sliding. Let's see the way that the other one was bouncing around. Yeah, it's a similar thing we have when we put the cars through the rollers, because it's now twisted the chassis up slightly. We tend to spin the wheels. Yeah, we don't really turn left. But that's remarkable. There is no way you should still be alive, car. Fine, we will put you back in position. We will reset the cannon. We're going to have to give it another shot. I was expecting that to be well and truly dead. Okay, next shot we're going to hit the back of the car. This should survive that, in all honesty. Right, we will reset the cannon. There we go. That's the only way that I know of to reload it. I don't know if there is a button you can press to reload it. I think it's just reset the vehicle. Right, spin the cannon round. Make sure we don't miss. That would be very silly. Right, see if Grand Marshal can survive a second shot, this time to a different part of the car. Fire. Oh, we just scraped the back corner. Yeah, it will survive a second shot. I thought we were a little bit more central. A little bit fiddly to aim the cannon. You could go into... this is apparently the first-person mode. This is with the camera attached to the cannonball itself. Yeah, we're going to get an up-close and personal look very briefly at the back of a Grand Marshal. Now we're going to... Oh, we're going to pinball off some tree. This is a very bouncy cannonball. You sure you didn't load it with basketballs? Oh, we're still going. We're still going. We're still bouncing. Oh, dear. The Grand Marshal. That does not look particularly healthy. I will be honest with that. Right, we will tab to the Grand Marshal. Oh, that did a lot of damage. It bounced off the floor just before hitting the car. Take the handbrake off. It's still working! How are you still alive? You should not be. Look at that. I really thought that the combination of shooting the engine and shooting the back will wear the driveline. Admittedly, the bounce may have saved the driveline. The way you look that it's curved up the bodywork, that may have just about saved the driveline there. Okay. We're going to have to go for a third shot. It's no good. We're going to have to go for a third shot on the... I may have put the car in a bad place. I think I buggered it up now. Didn't realise that was where my cannon was resetting to. Oh crap, how are we going to get out of this? Hold on, slight panic. You can go over there. There we go. Cannon, you can go back. Bloody typical. Cannon, you can go over here somewhere. Car. Well, that car is still working. It's still driving just about enough to get it in position. Right, we'll have to put the cars closer to the tree line. Ooh. There we go. We don't really have steering anymore. We don't really have that good a return. Oh, we flicked the wheel out. Is that... No, it's not really helped a huge amount. Yeah, that'll do. Right. Okay. Cannon has got slightly confused over here. Right. one more shot. Now, the fear I have here is that this may well end up tipping the car over and putting it on its roof if I hit it from the side. It's not the most maneuverable thing, a cannon. I will be honest. Right. The car is just about lined up. Are we lined up for a shot? Now, I could try and go for some elevation on the cannon, but we don't really need very much. We're still not traveling that far. We're going to give it a fire and quickly swap to the car. Ooh! It's still going! How are you surviving? We captured the cannonball. We're taking it with us. Look at this. Oh, there is no way. There is absolutely no way that this should still be working. It took a hit to the side. No, we're fine. We're dragging our exhaust a little bit. Right, I'm going to reset the cannon. We will get the cannonball out of the way and get the car back into position. I mean, look at this. It still has forward movement. We still have a kind of not. We don't really have steering anymore. That's not a surprise considering the state of that front wheel. We don't really. Oh no, look, there we go. Look at that. We can just about steer. If we go very slowly, we just about have sort of steer. It doesn't really resemble a Grand Marshal anymore. I will be honest. It doesn't really look that much like it. But look, it's actually got some control at lower speeds. The exhaust is held on by the force. That's okay. We will line this up for another shot. Could it really survive four? I expected the cars to maybe survive one at best. You are doing far too well, Grand Marshal. Right, let's get the cannon turned. Ah, dear. Yeah, this is far... surviving far. Admittedly, from the side, you're not actually hitting anything important, but you are crumpling the body up in ridiculous manners that will often have the wheels so that they don't touch the floor or something equally silly. But nope, the car is okay. Right, we will again just have that little bit of elevation so that the cannonball can reach it with a bit more speed. Fire at the car. Ooh, that's bounced off the front. I don't think that really did much. It needs perhaps a little bit more elevation, I think. Oh no, has that... Oh no, there we go. It's a little bit difficult getting it to go forwards from a standstill because of that front wheel. But yeah, right, handbrake off on the cannon. That's always useful. Yeah, the old cannons, they had handbrakes and stuffs. That's, I'm guessing, bit of a car. Some part of the Grand Marshal. Amazingly, it isn't littering parts everywhere. I'm quite surprised. Apart from the exhaust that's kind of hanging off and whatever that was, it hasn't actually chucked parts everywhere. Okay, we need to get you back into some form of position. We want to kind of have it on this line here. There we go. It's aiming straight there-ish. Just about. That'll do. I think we've got to have it slightly... The car's not quite central on the line, so we've got to have it pointed that way, I think. No, maybe not. Maybe not. There we go. I'm not sure about that one either. That'll do. Right. We'll give it a little bit more elevation. Give the cannonball a little bit more speed. Oh, that's killed it. It got bounced off the roof. It's still bloody working. If it wasn't for the fact that it got tipped on its side, the Grand Marshal would have survived four cannonballs. That's quite impressive. That's quite a lot of... Can we actually kill it in one shot? Now, that's what I'm curious about. Because I would have expected it to have been killed in one shot to the bonnet. So we're going to go and drift a cannon. Whoop! We've spun out a cannon. It's fine. We'll just do some celebratory donuts with it. There we go. If we go a lot closer so that we definitely can't miss and have all the full force of the cannonball fired straight at the front of the vehicle... There we go. Right, handbrake on. Fire that at the Grand Marshal. That's kind of bounced off the bonnet slightly. That should be absolutely fine. I mean, I wouldn't have wanted to be a passenger in this vehicle particularly. I mean, the driver, neither the front seats have got off particularly well. I mean, the back left passenger may be the only one that's kind of okay, even then. Not really. Okay, we may have been a little bit too close to the to the cannon on that occasion. get that car back parked again. I'll have to rearrange the cannon anyway. Car, stop rolling. I should have put the handbrake on. Never mind. Okay, let's actually go for the engine this time. Whoop. Bugger it. Right, we're going over here. We will fire from this angle. And hopefully we are... That looks aligned to me. Just about. We'll wiggle it a little bit more. There, that should... Clip the engine. Nope, we're not aligned. The thing is just pinged off into space. The car is slightly rolling backwards. It's fine. The only thing we did was slightly scrape the fender. Right, I should put the handbrake on this time. Ah, dear. Right, we will kill this car. We will kill this car in maybe two shots, I think. Right, okay, this is the line we want to line it up on, I think. Whoop. From this distance, it may bounce before it gets to the car, or it may hit it. Oh, hit it square on the bumper, but I don't think it did that much. Oh, okay, no, I lied. That did quite a lot. We're fine. How are you okay with that car? There is no way. There is no way you should be okay with that. Fire, we go for a point blank. Oh, I pressed the wrong pissing button. Never mind. We'll actually go for a fresh car. We're going from point blank range. Can we angle? No, this is as low as the cannon goes. Okay, whoop, and round, point blank shot on the Grand Marshal. I think we may actually have the cannon slightly too high. Yeah, it might just be a little bit too high. Never mind, we're gonna go for it and fire. Yeah, it's just gonna go off the. we've well and truly made a flat packed one. It's a devious little bugger, this car. It is a devious bugger. It's a lot stronger than I expected it to be. Okay, cannon, we'll go over here. We'll do one more shot at the Grand Marshal. And hopefully we will kill it in this one shot with a cannonball to the engine bay. Right, there we go. That looks good enough to me. Right at the front. Okay, that's probably the cleanest shot. We didn't bounce off the bonnet or anything. That was a nice shot on the car. And... it's still bloody working. Admittedly, the steering is hurting slightly. The Grand Marshal is just too strong. Grand Marshal beats cannon, it seems. Or it can certainly survive cannon. That's not the outcome that I was expecting. Well, we will have to try with some other vehicles. Okay, the next car we're going to open fire on is the Honda Prelude. Now, this thing was pretty fragile when we took it down the downhill chaos course, so I'm hoping that we should do a lot of damage to it when we fire a cannon at it. Okay, well, we are lined up, going for a side-on shot first time, just to see what happens with the little Honda. Ooh. Little Honda has escaped down the road and looks like it's in... We've twisted the entire chassis. Yeah. Honda is not going to survive that one. In front-engine front-wheel drive. It's not going to survive that too well. Can we bend the chassis the other way? What can we really... Could we split a car in half? I don't think the physics engines allow you to actually split the car exactly in half. But we'll give it a good go using cannonballs. Right, back you up here. There we go. That should be just about right to hit the door and fire. That did a lot of damage. We've got the cannonball in the boot. It's fine. Yeah, turns out the Honda may not be quite as strong as the Grand Marshal. That's really taken an absolute battering. Okay, what happens if we fire at the back of the Honda? Maybe that's probably the best chance we have of having the car still working. Because, as I said, front engine, front wheel drive. If we hit the boot of the car, we might not damage anything too important yet. We're off-roading with the cannon. There we go, we should climb over them rocks. In fact, the rocks kind of irritatingly where I want to put the cannon. Whoop, that kind of helped, actually. Well done, thank you. That was a useful assistance. Right, we will, I don't know if that's lined up or not. That'll do. Right, fire. Oh! Straight in the back of the horn. I think the cannonball is still there. It is! The cannonball is still there, and the car is driving. Now, we may have to reset this to get that huge weight out of the back of it. If we get rid of the cannonball... The Prelude can survive, admittedly. Like, the steering is slightly wonky. There we go. I had the handbrake on. Still had the handbrake on. Now we're a bit better. Look at this go! It does have a tendency to spin out. Just a small bit, but... We've really made a compact Prelude. Oh no, we're not turning. We can turn right a lot better than we can turn left. So if we need to turn left, it's probably better to... Oh no, there we go. Got it going a little bit. Oh, we've found a ramp. Hey, we traversed a ramp. This is what it looks like. From first, just don't look behind. From out here, I mean, it's not too bad, aside from a strange driving position. It just looks like, you know, we've got a cracked windscreen and so on. We look over that way. It's, again, I mean, yeah, the roof's bent, but just don't look that way. That way. We've made a shortened Prelude, and it does still drive. It does quite good donuts as well. There we go. Celebratory donuts for a working vehicle. The way that wheel's... with the ridiculous toe we've got on that rear wheel, donuts are pretty good. For the Prelude. Right, what I'm going to try now is... Oops, I don't think I'm going to have a huge amount of control of parking this. That's just going to have to wait there. And if we reset this, and if we have a shot at the front of the Honda, can we make it really, really... It's not going to work after this shot, but I'm hoping we can make it really, really small. I don't know how well this is going to work, but never mind. We will just get it in position... Right, okay. That should work. And fire. Oh, I think it just bounced off the top a little bit. Yeah. Look at that. You wouldn't really be able to tell what car this was anymore. Now it's just a wreck. Okay, well, that was quite good fun to destroy. We shall... it did still survive a shot to the back, though. It can still drag itself around. We'll have a look for some other cars to make a mess of. Okay, we've got to give it a try. We've got to fire it at the van. See what damage we can do to the back of this one. There's plenty of target to aim for. Now, I'm pretty sure that if we hit the box of this, is the vehicle should still work, but it's going to tip it over, basically. Perfect. Oh, and there goes the cannonball out the other side. Aw, yeah. It's got to rip this. I did actually go all the way through. I'm quite surprised. A cannonball. I mean, it did bend. It sort of bulged that side, but the truck is still absolutely fine. What we may have to do, which is why I have the stuff placed over here first, in the first place, is that we may have to go up against the wall over here to try and stop the truck from falling over. The doors are already coming open. Oh, don't bump into that like a fool. There we go. We can turn it. I mean, it's... Oh, we slightly scraped the wing. Oh, no, it's still on. The wing mirror is still on. It's fine. Right. Truck can go there. Right. We'll reset you. Now we have... Oh, the doors have opened. Stupid things. Now the truck shouldn't have room to fall over. So, hopefully, anyway. Right. We will just aim that up a little bit. And fire straight at the side of the truck. There we go. Cannonball. Is going to bounce its way down there, and the truck should be absolutely fine. I mean, we've made a mess of the back bit, but there we go. Yes, indeed we are. Fantastic. Now we're going to fire at the cab, see if he survives as well when we do that. Spin the thing. Oh, have we got the... There we go. We're working. Let's try and figure out what line it is we need to... Very helpful doing this on the grid level. We can line it up better with these markings on the floor. Right, that should do it. Just raise it up a little bit so it doesn't bounce along the floor. And fire. Oh, a little bit too high. I thought that was enough. God damn it. I don't really want it to... I was trying to avoid it from bouncing up off the floor and clearing the cab, but as it happened, it just bounced. It just was too high. Okay, fine. We'll just go for the bounce off the floor option. There we go. Oh, that was a nasty one. That was a very nasty one. But I think the truck is still... God damn it. Stuff in here is sturdier than I expected. First putting them through the rollers, now firing a cannon at them. I mean, look at it. It's... there is only limited adverse effect. I think we've even got the... This is the best handling one so far. It took a cannon right to that front wheel. Okay, we don't really turn... We don't really turn to the right very well. There's not much in the way of steering. Okay, I'm going to now set this up to fire through the back doors of the van. Well, where they were anyway. We're going to fire through them, see what happens when it tries to leave that sort of like the front of the box bit. See what it does to the cab of the truck and so on. Right, line you up there. We may have to go for just a teeny bit of aiming up. And fire! Cannonball just seemed to have phased into the truck. Did it actually come out the other side? No, it didn't make it all the way through. It's sort of stuck in the stuck in the trailer bit. Okay. Right, I got to reset this truck. I'm not too fussed about the fact that one there was damaged at the front. Ooh, we'll also reset the cannon because the ball's rolling around. Okay, park you in front of the cannon somewhere. Whereabouts was the cannon aimed down? Oh, this one here, funnily enough. Right. Oh, it's opened the door. It's not fun when you cooperate, game. There we go. And fire. Yes, we cleared it. I'm pretty sure that yes, we did. We cleared the truck all the way through. Fantastic. That's what we wanted. it just took out the front wall. I was hoping it's going to hit the back of the cab. We may have aimed a little bit too high on that. There we go. Yeah, it's just skimmed off the top of the cab. Damn it. I was wanting to try and go through the windscreen. Okay, never mind. We shall reset. We shall aim again. And we shall try. Maybe we shouldn't go for... We do need a tiny little bit of upwards, I think, just to clear the back of the... There we go. That's in the cab. yeah, it is properly in the cab. There, in fact, it's in the driver's seat. The cannonball is driving... just about in the driver's seat. No, I got confused with what we were looking. Oh, there's stuff ahead of us. There is stuff slightly ahead of us. There we go. And there's plenty of debris. Now the cannonball's in the passenger seat. There is plenty of debris in the cab, and the driving position is slightly altered. But we're okay. Right. We will go for a head-on shot on the van. Could it really survive that? I don't know. Could you really survive a shot straight to the engine? I'm not sure. Judging by the ferocity that hit at, I'm not sure you're going to be that happy with that. Nope. Yeah. That killed it good and proper. Yeah, not surprised by that. Okay, the box truck is pretty good fun to shoot at, I have to say, with such a big target. I think we'll have a look at one more vehicle, see what carnage we can cause. Okay, the final vehicle that I will subject to the cannon. It is the Moonhawk. This is an estate version of the car. Well, since we're here, might as well just do that. We've made it a convertible on the driver's side and not a convertible on the passenger, and it's still working okay. I think the problem is the differential at the back. Because the chassis is so twisted, that wheel just wants to go in the air and spin. But look, that should not have taken that hit as well as it did. I was really expecting sort of stuff. If I'm not hitting the engine directly, I was expecting it to at least wreck the driveline or bend stuff in such a way that it would be undrivable. But these cars are really taking the hits. Okay, well, we're going to do it from the other side now. See if we can even out the convertibleness of this, or whether it will just roll onto its roof. It's likely just to end up on its roof, I think. But never mind. Can we twist the chassis the other way? Oh, it's on its side. It's not quite going to come down. I may have to go and give it... Does it look like it would work? That is the question. No, it wouldn't work anyway. We have killed it. Oh, now we've made it... Oh, we've kind of made it a T-top. Sort of. It's sort of a T-top. Moonhawk, can we... I don't know if this is any good at pushing cars over. Wooden wheels don't have much grip. Okay, they're not the grippiest of things, and this is quite a heavy object. Right, can we go and go on? Nope. God damn it! We'll give it a bit more of a run. I think the cannon itself may be a little too high for this. Go on. Oh, I wanted to see the T-top Moonhawk in all its splendor. I think we're just going to get stuck. We're slightly wedged. Okay. We will reset that one. It still took a fair punishment. Now, I'm wondering, could we get the cannonball all the way through this car. I don't think we could get the trajectory. You know what I mean. Trajectory. There we go. My brain cannot say that word. Can we get it through? I'm not sure we can. Get it through the back windscreen and out the front one without taking... Oh, we're looking the wrong way there. There we go. Ha-ha! Straight in the back of the Moonhawk. Okay. And fire. Oh, we did! That was straight through the car. Fantastic. That was a little bit too far. Now we're just going to roll forever. That was straight... Was it straight... I'm pretty sure we went in the... I'm confused now. The damage suggests we went over. Over, I don't know. Like, I would have expected the roof to have bulged outwards if we've gone through, but we have wrecked the back of it. We're going to have to reset that and try again with the outside camera when... when I know what I'm, when I can see what I didn't expect that to work at all. I expected just to get embedded. Oh dear, we've had a small accident with the cannon. I just expected that to get embedded in the boot of the vehicle. I didn't think we were actually going to make that one work. I'm never going to be able to do that again now. That was it. That was the one good shot. I think it was from about sort of this distance-ish. Right. Oh, there we go. And fire. Ah, yeah, I think that's probably what we did. I think we took the tailgate out. Yeah, similar sort of damage. We have put the rear seat kind of in the roof. We're still working, though. It's still absolutely fine, driving-wise. Okay, we will see if we can get it through the passenger windows. Where is it? I respawned the cannon. It's somewhere like over... I'm going to do the same stupid thing again, aren't I? We've got to respawn the cannon inside the car, aren't we? Yeah. Oh, no, we're okay. We're good. Right, I don't think... The cannon is going to go low enough to go through the windows, is it? If we reset that, don't have caps lock on by accident, otherwise it doesn't work. It's just going to, yeah, I think the windows are, bugger it. The windows are a little too low. Okay, for our final thing, I'll stick this car up against the wall so that it can't move anywhere. And we will give it a fire on, do we even actually do we hit the car from the front? I don't know. We'll do that next. Oh, well, we bumped the wall slightly. Nothing to worry about compared to what's about to befall it. Okay. This should probably... I mean, I would expect this to kill it, but the Grand Marshal survived a hit to the face, so who knows? The Moonhawk is a tough vehicle as well, one of the strongest vehicles in the game. There we go, right at the front. There was nowhere for it to move. That should have... It didn't kill it. It's still alive. Hell. That was right. I mean, we have lost steering. It's the steering damage that's more of the problem than anything else. It's the lack of steering. Fine. Okay. We can't quite get a nice shot on the car. We can't quite get it flat against the wall because the steering's knackered. But we will end with this shot on the Moonhawk. Hopefully it'll be a... we will have a mess of a car by the end of this. There we go. In the passenger side. I think the cannonball may still be in the car. Indeed it is. And the vehicle is still working. Well, there we go. We've proved yet again... The cars in BeamNG Drive can take a hell of a lot of punishment. The cannonball is coming with us. Yeah, even from an incredibly powerful cannon, and even when it's shot at various parts of the car, it still worked. And this is actually still driving relatively well. We still have steering in all directions. That's quite impressive. Well, there we go. That is it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. And until next time, goodbye.